guys of CY from PDG Khaki. Today I'm going to share some grading tips. How do you identify which card to grade, which card not to grade? What is the point you need to take note, and what is the thing that you have to take note during purchasing the raw cards or raw Pokemon cards? Okay, I create Pokemon contents. So if you do like, please subscribe, like and share. Thank you. Okay, let's go. I have a sub here from PSA. Just arrived today. Okay, today I break it open already on my Facebook Live. So this is the return. Okay, so let's go through one by one and you can see what is the problem. Okay, this is a Lugia first edition Neo Genesis. A PSA 8, we will go through that. It looks good, it looks clean, okay? The next one will be a Burning Shadow Charizard GX. It's a PSA 9, okay? Then we have a VMAX Rainbow Rare from Champion Path. It's a PSA 10. New cards are normally easier to get, okay? But I'm not saying you will get it, but it's normally easier to get because it's a new card, okay? This is also Champion's Path. My son on November, I took an express, okay? This is also from Champion Park, Charizard V. And then we have 4 Charizard GX from Eden's Fate. This is a 10. This is also a 10. Okay? This is also a 10. Okay? So, how do we get 10? How do we get 9? Sometimes people say, oh, you have to see that. Okay, but let me go through one by one the points that PSA go through. Okay, let's take this Lugia for instance. Okay, it looks pretty clear the camera, right? But can you see the print line here? Okay, these two. Okay, these two print line. The back looks clean, no whitening, nothing. Let me zoom in. Okay, you see there's nothing, no whitening, the surface is good. But why you get a 9? Hey, why you get an 8? Sorry. Because of the green line. Okay, there's nothing on the surface. So the 10s are easy to identify, but I will go through later. This is the Buzzard Burning Shadow. Why you get a 9? The centering is good, there's no surface. I checked this card personally before I sent it over, but I think you can see here. There's a white, very white dot here, okay? Okay, so without further ado, let me take a raw card to show you how do I identify what to grade, what not to grade. Okay. Okay. We have to segregate the vintage and the modern card. Okay. The modern card are easier to grade because they are new and they don't have so much problem. But it also depends on the print run. Whether is it centered, the centering is it good, not good. Okay. Okay. This. Let me go to this Dark Gengar. This Dark Gengar is a very good example which I keep for this YouTube video. Okay, as you can see, there's nothing on the surface, the surface is good, okay? So when we see a card, in my perspective, the whitening is always the most important part. Okay, the whitening, the behind of the card, is there any whitening? As you can see, there's whitening. Then we go to the edges. Is it brown enough? Is there any whitening? Is there any bend? Okay, then they will go to the surface. Surface, what do we talk about surface? First, we see the holographic. Okay, is there any scratches? Dust particle, that will cause the scratch, okay? So, how do we take care of cards? I will go through another video. So, look at the back. Back is also important. So, you see, look at the back. You can go. Okay, there's a small dot there. You see, can you see there's a small dot there? Here there's a dot. Okay, here there's a dot. So this card will probably get a 7 on the surface. The front is okay. Okay, after surface, then we go to the centering. The centering is it left heavy, left right heavy, top heavy, bottom heavy? Same applies to the back, okay? But they will always prioritize. For me, I always prioritize the front part first. Okay, the front is okay, the front looks good. Then we turn. Then we see how is it. Okay, this is for vintage card that cuts. It's old already. So of course there's some stretches here and there. So you must be very careful when you purchase vintage cards. Okay. Now we go to the modern card. The modern card. Let's take This Charizard VMAX from Shiny Sun Japanese. It is normally new cards, modern cards have no problem with the surface, okay? Because of course it's new, like, it's brand new from packs. And what I always take note on the cards itself, when I first open the card, I will see the centering of the card. The centering, the left, the right, the top. Recently have a lot of problems, but yeah, this is what you can get. Then I'll go to the back, also see the centering. For Japanese card, a bit tricky. You can't see really the centering, but normally Japanese card quality are much better than English card. So then you will see white. You then check is there whitening. Then you go to the edge. Is it round enough? Is it squarish? So squarish normally is not very good. Then you go to the surface. Normally you do not have any problem with the surface because it's a modern card. So some pro tips before you go and purchase some raw card for people, like say, they say it's fresh from packs. Fresh from packs, okay, so what do you check for fresh from packs? Of course, read the light review. Don't do at night, okay? Do not do at night, you can't see light, okay? You need sunlight. So the first thing you of course, like I said, you see the centering, then the surface. Okay, always tilt your cup. Always tilt your cup. Don't hold it and see, hey, it's okay there, very nice. Always take your cup, tilt left and right, left and right. Of course, don't drop the cup, okay? The owner will be very angry with it and you have to buy it. So you take the cup, you see, is there any things, any surface, scratch it. Oh my god, this cup is so beautiful. So you see, you can see, then you turn the back, also the same thing. Because what happens, sometimes you put your cards, it happens to me, sometimes I put my cards here. Then maybe a coin or a pen drop on it, then you will have a thing. The dent inside, and that will be very, very heavy penalized by PSA, okay? So this is the pro tip I can give for nominating what to submit to PSA, because the grading fee is not cheap, plus the time, the turnaround is very, very, very high, because a lot of people are sending their cards there, okay? So as you can see, this Charmander, the centering is not perfect. The right is more heavy. I mean, this, the left is more heavy than the right, okay? That's why you can see that the centering is not perfect. But nevertheless, it's not the only criteria, because what they see is the overall of the cup. If the overall of the cup is good enough, they will give a 10, okay? But different company have different grading standard. I will go through it in other videos, okay? The PSA, the BGS, and the CGC. So this is what I have to share today. And if you find my video is interesting and is knowledgeable for you, please like and share and subscribe. And I will make more content regarding Pokemon cards, okay? Because I've been collecting for a while, since base set, okay? So please be safe, take care of yourself for this virus outside, and enjoy collecting. Thank you so much. Bye bye, guys.